systems being activated. So it's important, to put that into perspective. So we have the thymus gland, where you have the T cell formation, the tonsils, and where you have they are able to distinguish invaders for destruction. The spleen is able to filter blood and distribute the T and the B cells. We don't have time to go into all the nitty-gritty of the macrophages and the eosinophils and basophils, the suppressor T cells and the natural killer T cells, and all these aspects. But we just know that it is a wonderful system. And if God could put a system like that in place to handle physical invaders, is not my personality much more important that God will even come on earth and be a template for me to return and for you to return to at one moment with him? So this is so amazing. I just love it so much. So I love this text. It says, His divine power had given unto us all things for life and godliness through the knowledge of him that called us to glory and virtue. And that's taken from 2 Peter 1 and verse 3. It is powerful. So what God did in the beginning, he gave him all the things he need to be healthy. And to be healthy translates to being happy. One cannot be healthy, happy unless one is healthy. And happiness is found only in loving God and living in alignment with his design for life. We call those the laws of health. And so in the book Education, page 99, it says, to transgress his law, physical, mental, or moral, puts one out of harmony with the universe and invite discord, anarchy, and ruin. You see, it's a battle for the mind. So don't just think immune responses are just immune responses for the body. These stuff that bombard us all the time, the bacteria, fungi, viruses, parasites, even laws made by man, it's a battle for the mind. It is polemo, a battle of ideas, ideology. For God made man to glorify his name. In the book God's Amazing Grace, 377, it says, God created man for his glory, that after test and trial, the human family might become one with the heavenly family. And if you notice this map, and this is not racism or anything, you notice that this kind of looks like, the human skull, the human mind. You see, God only made one race, which is the human race. Everybody has eyes and hands and skin. It doesn't matter the size, shape, or color. The idea is that we were made in the image of God, body, mind, and spirit. And God wants to save all aspects of us. And so there are things that we need to understand that God has placed us in the world, especially as his people, as Christians, to bring light to the world, as Joseph did, as Daniel did, because the systems of the world are out of alignment with God. Ephesians chapter 6 says, we wrestle not against flesh and blood, principalities and powers, the rulers of the darkness of this world, spiritual wickedness in high places. So what did God do? God gave us a very important component of our lives that comprise of seven layers, seven characteristics. Daniel chapter 1 and verse 4. Remember, in Revelation 14, it says we must come out of Babylon. What does that mean? In our minds, because it's not about geography. The Babylonian thinking is about the use of force, the use of coercion and bribes to get people to follow its way. Now, we live in that system, but we don't even understand how it manipulates us. To survive that system, we need strong immune systems. It says, children in whom is no blemish. To have no blemish, one must follow the laws of health. That is critical because where do we get the laws of health? Not in Babylon, in Jerusalem. But well favored, because the natural result of the law of cause and result is that when you have a healthy lifestyle, you're going to look good, you can think straight, you can solve problems. Skillful in wisdom, the ability to solve problems. Cunning in knowledge, have information. Understanding science, know how things work. And such as had ability in them to stand in the king's palace. Why? Because the leaders and movers and shakers of this world have a way of thinking, which is they are built into the economy, but it is in conflict with God's design and physiology. So we must be able to help them, like Daniel did, like Joseph did, like Esther did. God designed us to have that information to be able to save those who need saving, who are in Babylon. But for us to save them, we must not be Babylonian in our thinking. And then it says, and whom they might teach the learning and tongue of the Chaldeans. So we need to understand how the system works. We live in a system, that the allopathic system, that has wonderful scientific discoveries, wonderful diagnostic tools, and so we cannot throw them out the door. We must understand how they work and now use those systems to apply God's intervention for health, because it's not simply about having the body operating. It's body, mind, and spirit. So God designed in the beginning how we should eat, and he has put in his creation the food that have the components to build a healthy immune system. But today we are not eating like that which is on the right. We are eating like that which is on the left. We are living differently. So when God made man in Genesis 1, he gave him three things. He gave him, number one, his work. Now, work is not chore. Work is teaching. So as he tended to the plants, as he nurtured the garden and he looked after the animals, he was learning about the character of God. Everything in law, in nature is governed by law, because everything in nature is made up of solid, liquid, and gas. And all solids, liquids, and gases are governed by law. How do we know? Well, think about it. How did God make the animals? How did God make the trees? He says, he spake and it was done. Now, sound is the vibration of air. So as God sounded his voice, vibration of air, things came into being. And that is why God gave us things like singing. So when we sing wonderful hymns, we reconfigure the environment around us and bring healing virtue. That's how God, some of the mechanisms that God is able to work. We go out among the plants, the vibrations. You know, people think when you talk like that is new age. It's not new age. God spake and it was done. When we speak, it must be because our minds understand what God intends for us to understand. Because the enemy cannot create anything new. What does he do? He hijack and distort that which God has designed for our happiness. You see, he was the light bearer, the Lucifer. He was Lucifer, bearer of light. Unfortunately, he corrupted that light. He became darkness. Now God is looking for you and for me. He says, here's what God says in Romans chapter 8. He says, I am the light of the world. If you follow me, you shall not walk in darkness. Then he turns around and says, what? Ye are the light of the world. Well, this may shock you, but really and truly he's saying, if you follow the light, then you will be another Lucifer. Lucifer is not a bad term. It's just badly understood. So we ought to be light bearers. God is looking for new light bearers to vindicate his character. And the only way that could happen is if we follow God's ideal in terms of the laws of health. So what about this immune system that we're talking about today? How do we understand it? Well, what really is immunity? You know, what is this thing? Well, there may be different ways of looking at it. However, in medical terms, it's our ability to resist an infectious disease. But remember, disease is only an effort of nature to free the system from conditions that result from a violation of the laws of health. So what we call disease is really the immune system doing its work to save us. Now, on a deeper level, it is our ability to resist harmful influences. So not only infectious agents, but influences. So we always say she was immune to criticism, because criticism affects and can engage the immune system as well. Immunity is our ability to protect ourselves. God put that in there. As a matter of fact, God wants to restore us to self-governance, because when God made Adam, Adam had self-governance. He was designed to act like God, to govern himself without external input. In Romans chapter 1, it says, the just shall live by faith. The just? What are the just? The just are those who are made right. Those who are made right, and that's why we have an immune system to keep us right, we live by doing what is right in governance of self. Therefore, if I understand my immune system, there are some things I would not put in my body. For those things are going to damage my immune system and short circuit my connection with my creator, who I am designed to glorify, to reflect his character in my own and make him known. So mental and emotional and spiritual immunity all relate to our physical being. So we see immunity is not only about infectious disease. That's why we say the modern medical system in which all of us are educated does not consider other aspects generally. It is looking simply at the physical, but you have mental, emotional, and spiritual immunity as well. Now, immunity actually requires us to be able to distinguish what belongs to me, my own DNA, and what does not belong to me. So anything I put in my body that does not, is not part of my DNA or the DNA that God designed it to be compatible with, the immune system is going to be raised. So for example, do you know that whenever you have intercourse, that your immune system, women, is engaged, and God put a mechanism to suppress the immune system when you are in love with somebody so that you can have a pregnancy. It is that deep. It is telling us that God is particular, very particular. So the immune system, that sense of self, it also implies the ability to recognize what is good for us, nutrients in the physical, friends, and what is harmful to us, enemies. So if you think about it, there is a science today called nutrigenomics. It is how food impacts on our genes. So the DNA in food, healthy food that God designed, is impacting on our genes. They call those epigenetic things. But the truth is, God's design for life is the best design for our immunity. So once any harmful cell or influence is identified, then the immune system is going to be engaged to destroy that, because we are designed for life. If we didn't have an immune system, we're talking here about physical, mental, spiritual, moral, I don't think the human species may have survived for this long. So think of the immune system as having different aspects. As God is Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, he made man body, mind, and spirit. He also made our immune system tripartite. So God is triune. We are tripartite. The immune system is also tripartite. The number three is one of God's signature numbers. So three, whenever you see three things working together, it's a powerful. God is saying, my signature is there. When you, the one who signs on the dotted line means I have the power, I have the resources to execute whatever is in the document. You and I are like documents, and we get to choose whose side we are on. So we have our protective services, and they are like physical barriers, like a wall to prevent entry into the body. And we'll look at what those are. Then we have the innate immunity. So most people, when they look at immune, they look at two, innate and adaptive, but they are really three, because remember, three, God made us in his image, and three is God's number, one of his numbers. And so he put the signature of three. Then we have like the axis, the HPA axis and HPG axis. You see three being a signature number all the time. Even think about it, our body fluids are signature fluids, so we can identify who we are through saliva and blood and semen and all these things. Semen is signature fluid. When you put your semen into somebody, you are putting your signature, your DNA. You know, my substance was not hid from thee when I was made in secret and curiously wrought in the lowest parts of the earth. My substance, my DNA, my substance was thy substance was not, my substance was not hidden. Think about it. He says here, even when there was no organ, no hand, no feet. Yes, it's so amazing that God could create these things. Yeah, and then we have the innate immune system that acts like border agents, and they can call for backup, that innate immune system. Then we have the adaptive immune system, who is like your internal enforcement. And this aspect is one of the aspects that people study a lot. But remember, we have three aspects to our immune system, not only one. So let's look at the first line of immune defense or protective surfaces, like our skin and mucous membranes. So the skin is external. It prevents things from entering. That's why when you get a cut, you breach those protective surfaces. When you don't take care of your digestive system, you know, you can get H. pylori and so on. So the immune, the mucous membranes, they are like, think of it like your internal skin. And I tell you, God is so wonderful that he made it that way so we can be protected. You have the microbes pass these barriers when damage occurs to the tissue. If you get a cut, a bruise, a bump, you don't take care of your digestive system, you eat junk and so on. Well, I don't even want to say junk food because junk is not food. So if you keep the wound clean on the skin and maintain your digestive system, the GI tract, you maintain the respiratory system, then these barriers are getting stronger. They can do their work. So when you have asthma, bronchitis, all these things is called there's a breach in the protective surface. Then you have the innate immune system, because sometimes these barriers are on a breach because they are under constant attack. The body is now going to initiate inflammation, and the inflammatory response is designed to kind of cordon off the area. Then you have the macrophages that are like the what we call border patrol, just like in your country. Man cannot do anything that is not already in him. The reason man can design a defense system for a country is because there's a defense system in his body that God made. Whether it is a car, a bicycle, anything that man has made, it is because it is already in him and the situation brings it out. So whenever they detect these intruders, they can call up the backup system like your neutrophils and your natural killer cells and so on. And there's a wonderful thing that they can do as well, in that they can inform the adaptive immune system. There are some intruders, please be on guard, be ready, because we don't want Iris, we don't want Johnny, we don't want Susan, we don't want Angela to become to be destroyed. Then there's the third line of defense. Whenever you see sometimes there's war and the invaders may get past the border, when they are recognized, you have antibodies are created, and these antibodies attach to these invaders, and they call those antigens, and they tag them for destruction. And the beautiful thing is that if they come back again, they're already tagged. So the immune system is going to race towards protecting the integrity of the organism. Beautiful you and handsome me. So you have the T cells are able to recognize these tags, and we talked about some of the aspects of the body where these are produced. And once the body has successfully fought off these invaders, then this part of the immune system is actually primed to recognize them again and to destroy them before they spread. Isn't that amazing? I tell you, God thought about everything. No being in the universe could have designed this system. We could not have evolved. There's also passive immunity, and this is where we have transfer of antibodies produced by the mother to the child. And so they are transported across the placenta during the last 1 to 2 months of pregnancy. And that is why in Patriarchs and Prophets, women are admonished to take care of themselves before and during pregnancy. Remember when the angel came to Elizabeth? When the angel came to Mary, when the angel came to Manoah's wife, he says, "See that you take care of yourself. Don't eat unhealthy food. Don't drink any alcohol because you affect the immunity of the baby." Remember, immunity is not just about the physical, the mind and the spirit as well. So, a full-term infant will have the same antibodies as the mother. So, mummies, grandmummies, daughters, you have, who have not gotten a baby as yet, please remember, the design of God is that the law of cause and results will always happen. You want a healthy baby to pass on immunity, then you must be healthy as well. Now, these antibodies, look at that, will protect the infant from certain diseases up to 1 year or longer if they are breastfeeding, up to 1 year. And that's why, you have to think many, many babies. I remember when I took my son to John Hopkins to do a surgery. Guess what? I saw little babies a few months with pacemaker on. I saw little babies with some conditions. My heart bled. Maybe those mothers didn't know. They just lived and then they happened to get pregnant. And so the babies are affected. They come into the world and then we have the problem. Now, one of the things that affect immunity is antibiotics. We are just taking so much. What they do, they have an impact on bacteria. But the thing is, we have a gut microbiome that is loaded with beneficial bacteria. So all microbes are not bad. So antibiotics are going to kill the friendly bacteria and allow yeast and the other infectious bacteria to grow. And so there is going to be an imbalance. Remember, yeast is a fungus. God's design for fungus is to return organic matter to dust. When organic matter is returning to dust, what is that? It is the death principle. Overuse of antibiotics is also creating what we call antibiotic resistance. So when we take a lot of antibiotics, we weaken the protective surfaces because that's why sometimes your children, you give them a course of antibiotics, they start to get thrush. What is thrush? That's the fungus that is growing. And it weakens the innate immune system, the body's natural inflammation generating system that is protective in the initial stage. So, because of the abuse, a lot of the antibiotics are ineffective against colds and flus, viral infections, fungal infections, and parasites. So we find a proliferation, and then we have to use antifungal and antihelmintics and so on. It is usually ineffective against things like sore throat and sinus infections. How many people you know? Ear infections, respiratory infections, and bronchitis. So we are using more and more drugs. That puts a heavy demand on the liver to detox these things, and it actually weakens the immune system. Stronger, longer duration. When we use a lot of antibiotics, especially, do you know, we predispose, especially the male, to a lot of STIs in the future, because God designed the balance. But when we destroy the balance, then infection in the future is increased. So God has designed some alternatives. Well, they call them alternatives, but they're not really alternatives. Really, the antibiotic, the pharmaceuticals are the alternative. So it's not that you never use, because there are situations where you may need them. And I always, my philosophy is this. You utilize that which you need based on the circumstances that you need. So just about all branches of medicine, there are positives. Now, please don't think that because many people advocate plant medicine that they understand what they are doing, because many people, they develop what they call these kitchen sink remedies, where you throw a lot of different plants together that are good for something, and you actually can do harm to people. Because that's not how things work. So that is why God asks us that we must understand the science. It is the science, the same science that is in the system that God designed, because God designed science. When we study plants, there's a course we have to do called plant chemistry that will tell you about the chemical components in a plant and what they're able to do. That is why we can, let's talk about one. Salicylates in plants is where they got the idea to make painkillers from. Yeah, so salicylates actually affect pain centers. So because they have studied that, they can now make a synthetic salicylate. So don't think it's everything that man has gotten from nature. But remember, salicylates do not exist in isolation in a plant. And the problem is when we isolate components and concentrate them, then we can have other effects. So things like silver and garlic and berberine, things like your golden thyme and stuff, they have berberine in there, elderberry, antiviral, olive leaf, you have echinacea and your vitamins and so on that you get from your food. Very powerful. So these are some what we call antibiotic or antimicrobials, I could say, that you have. You already have garlic in your house. You already have golden seal in your house, and many people have vitamins. You already have pumpkin seed and all these things. Use them daily. Now, we have to be careful with antibiotics and make sure that we eat a healthy diet. To know what to eat, you go back to the book of Genesis. You can maintain a healthy gut flora with probiotics. Now, we have fermented foods here. It's not that I'm recommending fermented foods. I'm just saying that's out there. So you may hear that fermented foods. When you are trained, you're not only trained in that which is good. We are trained across the board. Skillful in wisdom, cunning in knowledge, understanding science. What does that mean? That we must know what to use where and when, and not because you're missing a platform. Oh, Brother Bob is saying use fermented food. No, I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that's out there. That's one of the things people use. However, it's not that there are no benefits to it, but this is not what we advocate. There are better things, and we're going to talk about those. You have hydrochloric acid and enzymes that can help with weak digestive system, because most people have weak stomach acid. And of course, doing your periodic cleanse, that's a whole other thing. So the second line of defense, we call the innate immune system. You have other plants like your turmeric, your omega-3 that you get like from your flaxseed and so on, your vitamin C. Remember, many of these plants contain components that the system needs. So when you give your omega-3, it helps the system to work better. Many of the cells, like your mitochondria, need your omega-3. Your mitochondria need vitamin C to work. You need the minerals. If you want to boost the immune system, vitamin A and D and zinc, very important in detoxification and helping components to work better. And then, of course, one of the reasons why we have a lot of heightened immune response is because we just live in a stressful world. But remember, stress is only in our perception. Because we have conformed to the economy, based on the economy, the demands of the economy is put into the curriculum, and the curriculum is how we are educated, then we are going to make decisions based on how we are educated. That is why God led the children of Israel out of Egypt into the wilderness, where there were no distractions, so that they could be taught again. One of the first things that God did to help build their immune system is that he brought them to a bitter pool, the pool of Marah, but they didn't want to drink the water. Now, we know today that bitter stimulates the digestive system to work better, to produce more hydrochloric acid, and it stimulates the liver to detox. Digestion parallels comprehension. Detoxification parallels removal of sin. Because they didn't drink that bitter water, they could not understand the word of God, the commandments of God, and they could not be purged from their Egyptian thinking, and therefore they didn't go to the promised land. Let's not make the same mistake today. So when we are in the wilderness, we have to depend on God. There are no supermarkets, there are no pharmacies, there are no video arcades, there is no Wi-Fi. And so we are cool and calm and collective. Why? In the wilderness, God always provides an oasis. He always provides a palm to shade. Oasis gives us like a respite, water. He is the living water. A palm, he's the cooling shade in the burning sand. And cactus, nourishment, food. He says, I am the bread of life. And then, of course, you have like your astragalus, your beta glucans for your third line of immune system, that system that aids in the production of the antigens so that you can recognize invaders if they come again. And then you have now your self-esteem, your thoughts. What is your concept of yourself? Are you a people pleaser? Because people pleasers always say yes when they want to. They have weak immune system because they lie to themselves. And the scripture always tells us that thou shalt not tell lies. God says, I am the way, the truth. Truth and light go together. Lies and darkness go together. So many people who think they are in the light are actually in darkness, and that's why they are sick. Plants don't grow well in darkness. They grow best when there is light. Then you have the phytocannabinoids, an aspect of health that we are discovering since the studies have been done on plants like marijuana and hemp. Now, because of the negative publicity, the negative understanding, should I say, of plants like marijuana, when we say phytocannabinoids, because it's the cannabinoid that was studied in these plants, people have a negative thing towards it. Now, there are many different cannabinoids. We actually have an endocannabinoid system in our body, in many organs that respond to endocannabinoids. And not all are bad. THC is psychoactive, but CBD is not, and CBG, they are not. So there are other plants that we have been using all the time that have endocannabinoids, like echinacea that we use to boost the immune system in flus, like kava kava. These have endocannabinoids as well, So this is why we know God put the components in there. He expects us to live off the bad because of our temperance understanding and judiciously use the good. So God made the tobacco plant. He never said to smoke it because we don't have the system, the enzyme pathways to break down nicotine. But there's the tobacco hornworm that has that, the ability to digest and break down nicotine. So nicotine is not for humans. All the plants that God made are good, but it's not necessarily good for humans to use because humans are not the only organisms that use plants as food. Then we have regular fasting and detoxification. God tells us that two meals are better than three. So when we have a two meal a day plan, we have what we call that intermittent fasting. Guess what? You increase growth hormone production by over 2,000%. And growth hormone is important in helping the immune system to function better. Growth hormone is important in your ability to remember and to put on muscle and to love and to have a clear mind, to rest and all these things. Detoxification is important because we are just bombarded by so much. And so as we detox, especially cellular detox, we are able to push off toxins and the immune system has its time to rest. So again, we have gone through what is immunity, mental, emotional, and spiritual immunity, all related to physical immunity. We have a sense of self that is very important. Here is one that is very interesting. The thymus actually sits above, the chest there. And when you point to yourself, you point actually to your thymus. So there's a therapy called thymus therapy. But God gave us natural thymus therapy. Now, our sense of self-worth is going to determine our immunity as well. God has given us the ability to massage the thymus when we hug people. The thymus programs cells to recognize the enemy. Has if somebody ever hugged you and you just don't feel it? So having a positive self-esteem, a positive sense of self activates the immune system, while having a poor self-image not only weakens it. And so our ability to stand up and say, be confident in me, the one that God designed, for his glory, sometimes is weak. And there are systems in the world that are designed to destroy your sense of self. We are not a thinking people generally. We are conforming to whatever is said. So during the COVID period, you had to stay 6 feet apart. People were not interacting, no hugs, no nothing. There was no thymus massage, and people's sense of self began to diminish. And so we had to be creative. We had to now we had to now stimulate the electromagnetic fields around us by engaging our hearts. So when we love people, we have to talk to them. And so that's why we had the Zoom platforms now. So even though I can't touch you physically, I'm touching you because I'm seeing you. But God designed that we be in contact with each other. The next thing is the biological terrain. This is very important because the biological terrain is the environment in which the cells live. It's where the cells take up oxygen, nutrients, and where waste is removed. As a matter of fact, the biological terrain is also called the lymphatic fluid. It's where you happen and where I happen in that context. So Rudolf Virchow, he was a contemporary of Louis Pasteur. Now we today, most people, should I say, accept the Pasteur theory of disease, which is that germs cause disease. So the response is try to kill the germ. So this Rudolf Virchow, he said that the health of the body cells depended on their chemical makeup, and this chemical makeup depended in turn upon the kind of food that the individual eats. Now, Dr. Tilden also said the same thing. He says, food that is supplied with a preponderance of base material, alkali material, is going to develop what we call a rational vaccination. Isn't that awesome? Food provided with a preponderance of base material, alkali material, would help the individual to develop what we call rational vaccination. This is what we're talking about. Real vaccination is when we put the material God said to put in the body and we follow the laws of health. So here's what he said. If I could live my life over again, I would devote it to proving that germs seek their natural habitat, which is diseased tissue, rather than being the cause of disease. Example, mosquitoes seek stagnant water, but do not cause the pool to become stagnant. But for most people, because we think that bacteria, fungi, viruses, and stuff cause disease, we try to kill them. But remember, think, when have we been able to kill all the virus and fungi and bacteria? Dandian says no. The next thing is that most animals, when they are sick, they don't eat. They don't eat. That's why fasting is important. The research has shown that the people who fasted when they got COVID, more of them recovered. Edward Shook, here's what he said. They will show you illustrations of minute living organisms which are found in sputum or pus taken from diseased tissues or secretions. That's true. Probably at first sight, you are astonished. Then you wonder, can this be true? Yes, it must be true. There they are. We've seen them right in the pus, plain as can be. How awful that such creatures can live and destroy our bodies without our knowledge until it's too late. Surely these doctors have discovered the truth. They are right. The germs must be killed. But we kill so much germs and we still have disease. But wait a minute before you jump to such a conclusion. I just love this narrative. We find the fly on the garbage, which is composed of decaying organic matter. Is he, the fly, the cause of the garbage? Or does the garbage breed the flies? We find the white maggot in decaying flesh. Was he the maggot, the cause of the death? And what are these creatures doing there? Listen, they are eating, they are consuming, doing away with decaying matter. In other words, the presence of a microbe is the result of unhelpful conditions. This is the biological theory. Therefore, the most important thing in immunity is the health of the host and not in trying to destroy the microbes. In other words, maybe we have gotten it a little bit wrong. So Dr. Henry Bilyeu says, I came to the conclusion that germs do not, they do not, they what? Do not underline in your mind, they do not initiate a disease state of the body and appear later after the person becomes ill. In other words, tissues become diseased by our lifestyle choices. We produce free radicals. We don't have enough antioxidant. We eat junk, so the body don't have the components. These things, when you have free radicals, they are looking to steal electrons. Where do they steal it from? The tissues in our respiratory system, in our digestive system, in our endocrine system. They steal electrons from these tissues. The tissues become damaged, and that is a breeding ground for all microbes. So a healthy body is your best defense against disease. So the health of the organism, and that's why God says, in 1 Corinthians 10:31, whether therefore you eat or drink or whatsoever you do, do all to the glory of God. Oxygen is very important for the immune system. Why? Because most harmful microbes and cancer cells are anaerobic. They don't like oxygen. So you want to oxygenate the body. Breathe deep air. Practice your deep breathing. Breathe well. Women, loosen the waist so that the diaphragm can arch down and the lungs can be filled. Fashion of today is destroying health. Most women are shallow breathers, one because of the fashion of the day, and also because of high stress. You have to protect yourself so much. When God says, bear ye one another's burden, even in the church, people can't trust anybody. Should they breathe shallow? Because you have to always be on the alert. Increasing oxygen levels in the blood helps destroy infectious organisms and cancer cells. So learn to breathe. You can actually oxygenate by eating a lot of whole foods. Go to the by the beach. When you go by the beach, the crashing of the waves creates hexagonal water. Does have more oxygen, the hydronium atom. Then you have the waterfalls and so on. Even you can have these creating negative ions in your house. You can do that as well to oxygenate better. Sunshine is very important because UV light kills harmful microbes. Isn't that amazing? God, Jesus says, I am the light of the world. Think of the microbes, those pathogens as darkness. So light is going to destroy them. Light also helps the body to produce vitamin D and that is very helpful for the immune function. So if you live in a place that doesn't have a lot of sunlight, then you may be more prone to disease as well. What about fear? Fear lowers the immunity. So when we are afraid or stressed, the body produces what? More cortisol. Higher cortisol, more inflammation. Cortisol is also what we call a glucocorticoid, which means as the cortisol levels increase, the body is going to produce more insulin because a glucocorticoid is really glucose-based. So it suppresses inflammation and the innate immune reaction. So think about it. You have when you are stressed, we are actually destroying the immune system's ability to help us. So much more illness comes because of stress. But remember, when you go to do your evaluation, your medical professional may not have the time to go through all these things, and so they're going to give you something to suppress the symptoms. Helping the organism to be healthy is beyond symptomatic relief. So positive emotions enhance immunity. Why? Because people recover faster from disease when they receive tender, loving care. Bear ye one another's burden, and so fulfill the law of Christ. Have a positive mental attitude, and feeling happy enhances your immunity. A merry heart doeth good like a medicine, but a broken spirit dries the bones. Hugs, are very important. What they call timers to timers hugs. Have you not seen, sometimes, especially girls, they are sad and they meet their friend and they hold each other and they hug and they laugh and they cry because we stimulate the thymus gland to do its work. So hug, think about it. Hug, hug, hug is important. Touch, hug. When we hug, we press our chest together, enhancing self-esteem and self-worth and boosting the immunity. Or you can, a pat on the back does the same thing. Now we have to be careful how we touch people because there is such a counterfeit. It should not be so among us, my brothers and sisters. Hug people, touch people. I do it even on my job. I hug my employees and they know I'm not thinking any funny business. Sometimes they're going through a hard time. And I sit down with them, I pray with them, and they feel much better, Because people go through lots of difficult things, and God placed us here to be the light of the world. Belittling criticism harms the immunity. So when we speak unkind words to another person, we temporarily weaken their immunity. Husbands, wives, sisters, brothers, children. However, think about it. This, what we do that, it the effect on our own immunity is also worsened. So we worsen our immunity when we belittle others and we worsen theirs. What we put out is going to return to us. It's called the law of harvest. We need to practice good sanitation, washing the hands, clean food and water, and so on. But we need to recognize that if we sterilize everything, we actually weaken the immune system. So today, there's an overuse of sanitizers and cleaning agents. Remember, when you put these things in your body, the liver has to break them down. The liver breaks them down based on what I put in. Liver detoxification requires nutrients and good stomach acid and all these things. So the decline in infectious disease has been matched by a rise in allergies and autoimmune conditions. Why? We're killing off the bacteria and stuff, yes, but we are developing allergies. We need to be exposed to normal amounts of germs to develop a healthy immune system and our gut microbiome. So we need to have balance. Good nutrition enhances the immune system. So that's why we go back to Genesis chapter 1. We need our vitamin A, vitamin C, vitamin D, or zinc and selenium and all the other components, or omegas and so on. Get outdoors, get in the fresh air, be close to people, hug your family. Some people find it difficult, they're uncomfortable. But when we come to Christ, he says there is neither Jew nor Greek, bond nor free, male or female, in opposition to the beastly powers, where no those who are rich or poor, bond or free, those people cannot buy or sell because he's making laws to separate. When God is saying in Christ, all those walls are broken down. He says, be close to people, hug them, give them words of praise and encouragement. Have faith and courage. Believe you are healthy because it has in the mind and strong and you can overcome difficulty. Exercise, spend time to move, eat healthy, get sleep. Be relaxed, have fun, especially if you're diabetic. Diabetics lack sweet in their life. You need to learn to play some more. Be positive, have self-confidence. Keep things clean, but don't sanitize everything. In other words, just like children, they play in the dirt, they get some germs, and then their immunity is enhanced. And then, of course, because we live in a nutrient-poor environment, the soils are not what they are, we may need to take some supplements to build our immunity. So here is a recipe for reducing immunity. Stay indoors, avoid fresh air and sunshine, and wear a mask all the time. Stay away from people, don't attend church, and especially don't hug people. Yell at people, tell them they are stupid, criticize them, and off as often as you can. Be afraid, worry about infections constantly. Do you not see more people are dying more from fear and worry? Fear is one of the biggest tools of the enemy. Why? 1 John 4:8 says God is love. 1 Corinthians say God, love is patient, love is kind. Love does not hold a record of wrong. Love is not self-seeking. But it says fear had torment. Revelation chapter 21 verse 8 says, but the fearful, first set of people who would not see God's face, the unbelieving, the abominable. It didn't even talk about the fornicators and adulterers yet. The fearful. There is no fear in love. Close down gyms, don't exercise, be stressed, worry about money, worry about losing your job, sterilize everything. Don't worry about nutrition, especially vitamins and minerals. That's quackery. Suppress information about those things. And so, because of all of that, we have weakened immune system. So, we are trying to attack the microbe, which is the result of my ill health. And the body is trying to respond. But the immune system is too weak. So, I get what you call a disease, as opposed to strengthening the organism, you know? So, we have a lot of things. We are buying insanity. So, here are some remedies that you can use. So, of course, floral essence are helpful and essential oils and plants. So you have the buttercup. These are plants for low self-esteem. What does it do? They are components that enhance the body's ability to hear the voice of God as to your value. You have the sanctuary for weak-willed, dominated by others and self-neglect. So people who are weak. Chaparral, we know about that in cancer, cleansing the soul of psychic toxins and trauma. Echinacea, scattered sense of self due to trauma and abuse. Remember, it's the components in the plant. The plant is not doing that. God put the components so that he will build the body's natural systems. What does the enemy do? Try to hijack the natural system. So while we have the HPA axis, hypothalamus, pituitary, adrenal, to deal with stress, the enemy can hijack that system. How does he do it? By stimulating the amygdala, keeping us in fear, so that the HPA axis is continually working. When that is continually working, guess what? You shut off digestion, shut off reason, shut off our ability to rationalize. The olive, feeling depleted and exhausted, and so on. You have, of course, the penstemon, for feeling being persecuted, sagebrush, sunflower, and so on. Then you have your essential oils that we use all the time, or eucalyptus, frankincense, lavender, oregano. Especially, you know, if you're into medical missionary work, you would know about oregano, especially rosemary, tea tree, thyme. You have some respiratory challenge, thyme is very powerful. Rosemary, think about it. Rose and Mary, two beautiful ladies. It helps to improve the circulation and ease pain. Your myrrh, especially inflammation in areas like your thyroid and so on. Myrrh is very helpful. Your frankincense, cancer issues. These are anti-inflammatory. Cinnamon, eucalyptus, God has. And these are just a few. But you must learn how to use them. And then you have herbs that do different things, like your thyme and your yarrow, elderberry. These are antiviral. Your back antibacterial, like your echinacea, garlic, golden seal, myrrh, and so on. Antifungal, like your barberry, garlic, lavender, oregano, antiparasitic, the black walnut, clove, garlic, and so on. And they don't just do those things. These do many things in the body. Some people may know black walnut, for example, as antiparasitic, but black walnut is very powerful for helping with things like leaky gut, leaky brain, leaky skin. Yeah. So here is a Simply Immune formula, what we call a vaccine formula. You can have echinacea, oregano, grape, black walnut, thyme, and lemon peel. You make a tea And you drink that once or twice a day if you have a situation. It's going to really help. You need vitamin A for the mucous membranes, vitamin C for the immune cells to function. It's also an antioxidant. Besides being an antioxidant, you don't have vitamin C, then you can't get glucose into the cell. No glucose into the cell, mitochondria have no work to do. Mitochondria cannot work, then you are going to get very sick. So many people, while they have low energies, that they may have a deficiency in the operation of the mitochondria, the powerhouse of the cell. D3, very important for immune function, zinc to prevent viral replication. And of course, you have something called interferons as part of the immune system that warns neighboring cells, hey, there's a virus in here. Please protect yourself. So zinc does that. Interferons does that as well. You have selenium, which is very helpful in many immune systems. Chaparral. Well, listen, we cannot understate the importance of some plants. So I'm just going to go them through because our time is just about up. Chaparral, echinacea, elderberry, frankincense, garlic. Maybe next time we'll go through this one by one on what they do. Lemon balm, myrrh in some detail, olive, Oregon grape, pine, thyme. Isn't God awesome? Always remember, walnut, your black walnut, his divine power had given unto us all things that pertain to life and godliness. And I believe that we can bulletproof our immune system, our mind, our body, our spirit, not just the physical aspect, but we can bulletproof our mind because food is to the body what the word of God is to the mind. But if the body is not healthy, it will be difficult to bulletproof the mind with the word of God. The promises of God are the surest way to live a happy, successful Christian life. Great Controversy, page 599, 600 says, temptation often seems irresistible because of a couple things, because of neglect of prayer and the study of the Bible. The tempted one is unable to remember the promises of God to meet Satan with the scripture weapons. But angels of God are round about those who are willing to be taught in divine things and in the time of greatest need will bring to the memory the very truths that are needed. Thus, when the enemy comes in like a flood, the Spirit of the Lord will lift up a standard against him. May he lift up a standard in our lives as we seek to be the light of the world. God bless you guys until we see again. Have a wonderful evening.
Thank you so much, Brother Bob. We have truly learned how to bulletproof our immune system. Now, if anyone has any questions, you could type it in the chat, or you can raise your virtual hand and I will allow you to unmute and ask your question. We have someone asking, what would you use as an immune booster for a child of 4 years who has asthma?
All right, so there are some simple things that you can do. Number one, remove dairy and wheat and those kinds of foods. That's the first thing we do. So a lot of times the trigger are those things. They encourage leakiness in the gut. So those are primarily gut issues. We bequeath to children weakness in their gut, which is the second brain. And so the body responds because it cannot push toxins down through the respiratory system. Also, a lot of asthmatics are dehydrated. They don't drink enough water. They're always using sugar. And sugar, guess is what? Is food for your microbes. So you get infection. Yeah. So just by taking those things out and eating whole healthy foods without anything else, you can reverse asthma. And this is not just what I'm saying from a book. I'll give you an experience. There was a young man just about that age. His mother was working in my office, and every week he had to go to the hospital because he was having an asthma attack. So I gave her the same instruction. And then we added one thing, a very potent multi-mineral, not multivitamin, multi-mineral, because you may notice you're seeing zinc and stuff coming up all the time. And as we gave them that multi-mineral, let me tell you, he has never had to go back to the hospital because we took out the trigger. The cause, in case of sickness, the cause must be ascertained. And then we neutrified the body. So there was the creation of rational vaccination.
Okay. Brother Batten or Sister Batten, please unmute and ask your question.
Hi, good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
I have a 5-year-old son, and he has, well, I wouldn't say he had eczemas really bad, even though I breastfed and all of that, right? When he was born, he had jaundice, and they had to put him under the light and all of that. And I was producing breast milk, but they were relating it to that. So maybe I don't know if I was dehydrated, but anyhow, so he had eczemas really bad. So I tried to be honest, I did start to use, well, at that age, I couldn't use the slippery M and etc. But I, as he grew, I was trying to focus on healing the gut. But I'm being honest, I wasn't too diligent. I gave him some aloes, I gave him some slippery M. But what started to happen is that, like, if I put coconut in his mouth, his face would have swollen up. If he eat certain foods, he would have started to, his skin would have raised, or he might have vomited, right? So now he does not have the eczemas, but just like 2 weeks ago, he had a fever, and when the fever left, he had the raising of the skin and going down. It wasn't like the eczemas, but it was just like the skin raising and going down, raising and going. Like if he irritate the skin, like you know, if you touch a grass, a leaf, or anything like that, that is what was happening. So someone was advising me just stick to healing the gut, and it will resolve. But my husband wants us to do a liver cleanse. So what do you suggest? But as I tell you, the skin is very good. He is smally for his age. His mind is clear. He doesn't remember things I don't remember. His mind is very clear. He picks up things easy.
I'm happy that you said that
Yes.
because some of the people that are prone to eczema are brilliant people. See, this is one of the challenges. When we look at people, look at the whole. So the research shows that people who are intelligent are prone to eczema. And one of the reasons for this is that they do not always have an outlet to express themselves. So there's a lot of things in their minds that create some congestion. God has designed us to have what we call discharge. So you should not shut him down when he's asking many questions and when he seems to be annoying. It's not annoying. God designed him for purpose. And when we study the 12 tribes, we'll see the different types of personalities. And when we understand them, then we're able to manage them better. But what is happening is that probably think of him as having a cup that is full. The cup is full with all kinds of things. And any stressful situation will tip the cup over. So we call that a flare up. So he's not out of the woods because there are still some things that you may need to do to create a better situation. So let me just share, if you could indulge me for one little bit, to just share a little information on eczema, because that is one of the things that people have some challenges with. So I'm just going to study this slide for my sister's sake. So if you see here, it says most often found in intelligent people who are too much in their head. Yeah. So look at that. Lack of strong gut causes irritants to enter the body, which are eliminated through the skin. So he has a problem with pushing things down because he's living in his head, because he's brilliant. As a parent, if you don't understand how to keep him grounded, then every now and again he's going to have a flare-up. Reducing sensory stimulation of the mind and creating more focus on the body and the world of nature. So he must understand that not because he's bright, he must feel aloof in his mind as though he is above people. And sometimes we create that by complimenting them on their brilliance. And we are advised by God's servant not to do that. Then you have the TV, the cell phone, and so on. They create problems of hypersensitivity in the skin. Allow childhood diseases to run their course. So if he's been using a lot of antibiotics in the past, then you have what we call situations that are latent. And when you start to live healthy now, the body will recreate a crisis. So there are several things that could happen. Yeah. So things like your buttock and so on, because there is In eczema, there's a lack of flow from the interior to the surface. So remember, I said there's a lot of things inside him. You, as a mother, especially the mother, have to understand how to nurture him so that he can trust you, to be open with you without being judged. Even as a child, he already has personality.
You're welcome. We have you have another question?
No, I just wanted to say that it makes a lot of sense. It just makes a lot of sense. So thanks. I would keep trying on that end, right? Thanks.
Pray about it. Pray about it a lot. Ask God to pray.
We have Michelle Reed asking in the chat, how do you use black walnuts for fungus and parasites?
Oh, use it as a tea. You get you could get the capsule, you could get the extract, or you could get the powder is going to taste very bad. I tell you, the extract tastes very bad as well. You could get the capsule. So if you get the extract, you use most times the measurement is like a dropper full, one of those dropper, and you just coat it in the back of your mouth and you swallow it. Or if you use the tea, the normal herb, then you get a half a teaspoon in a teacup of water, steep it for 15 to 20 minutes, and then you use that. You shouldn't have to use it for more than 1 to 2 weeks. Yeah, and you can do that, let's say, once a quarter, because of our lifestyle, we kind of predispose to leakiness in general. And black walnut is going to tighten up the junctions by helping to control the zonulin levels. Also, take out wheat, the crackers, the cookies, the biscuits, the pastries. Those are, because remember, wheat has the gluten, gliadin, that increases zonulin levels and creates leakiness in the first place. And then, of course, your stresses and so on.
So Nicole, unmute and ask your question, please.
Yes, my question is, well, it's two. Will this recording be available for review later? And also, I have a sister who has precancerous polyps in her colon, and she is saying that it's the root cause is GERD. So I was trying to figure out, I was asking, is there anything that we can use for her naturally to help with that?
Well, definitely, like in those circumstances, I would suggest that she get a good assessment. Now, remember, the colon is where you eliminate things, you push things down, it's the major channel of elimination. So definitely it is congested. So excuse the language, but some people have a lot of crap in them that they are not letting out emotionally and mentally. And it is highly possible that over time she has not had that environment to get rid of that. And many times, you know, when we work with people and they get the crap out, because the crap in the mind translates to crap in the body. Sometimes when we do healing services and deliverance and so, after people are able to talk, because people are congested with ideas that they suppress because people don't want to listen to them and they find it stupid. No, you must never think another person's idea is stupid. We must listen and help them to understand and give them perspective. Sometimes these people go to the toilet and they put out a lot of stinky poop, and then they are better. So an assessment would need to be done in terms of where her emotions are, where her stress levels and so where those things are, and that will take a little more time. So now I just can't say do this and get rid of it. All problems are not so simple. If you can find a health professional, do an assessment, and especially let her do an assessment on her emotions. And that will, you know, bring some more clarity.
Who do you recommend that I do assessment?
Well, I wouldn't be able to recommend that on air. But you can talk to a lot of the providers here on Table of Christ. Should be able to direct you offline.
Okay, I'll try to connect with Dr. Ephraim. Thank you.
You're welcome.
And also, the recording is available on the TOC YouTube. So a lot of you are asking, it's available there. So you can get it from there, the TOC YouTube, okay? Our sister Lola is asking about someone's son who developed fungal infection from wearing a headphone at work. And they want to know if there's any herb that can help.
Well, first thing is that herbs ought not to be used like that. So people think you want to use an herb to replace a drug. That's not the intention of herb. When we use herbal medicine, it's to strengthen weakened systems and balance the biological terrain. Those are the primary purpose. So what the system is weak, especially what will happen, those radiation is going to affect the air. And there's a connection between your air and your throat through the Eustachian tube, and of course connected to your gut. So with all the stuff that is happening with the radiation, more than likely he's not eating well and so on, he may be prone to ear infection. An easy thing to help with fungal infection, FAST, a fast. A fast from technology, a fast from solid food, just a 3-day fast using green juices, especially things like celery and broccoli and kale. You'll be amazed. That is going to do wonders for his air. And let him not be using all this thing in the airs there and so on. They are not the best things. Leave the technology alone, keep it outside of the room, and tell him to learn some hymns to sing. He'll be fine.
Sister Rosemary,
I think
please
she has
ask your
answered the
question.
question already. She was
Yes.
the last one.
How would you treat Lyme disease? I've had it chronically for years, and there are studies from Europe that the liquid stevia that helps, but that's not cutting the dice right now.
All right. So now a lot of people have Lyme disease. Now, predominant primarily, would you be, sorry for asking, what race you are? Well, I believe there's one race, but there are differences between Caucasians and African descent and Mexicans. Which one would
Yeah.
you be?
Oh, I'm Caucasian from European descent.
So a
A
lot of
lot of
times,
Irish, a large, a lot of Irish genes.
So you come from a descent that use a lot of animal products.
Yes.
And so we inherit deficiencies in our own physiology by virtue of our ancestry. And sometimes there are some things that pop up in generations later. We have what we call weaknesses, become predisposed to certain things. Let me give you an example. So science has discovered that women who use a lot of birth control bequeath to their daughters a predisposition to polycystic ovaries. So right now we are seeing a lot of young girls with polycystic ovaries. And when we look back, it parallels when birth control, the pill especially, start to become popular. Now the women who use it would be the grandmothers and the mothers. So now the granddaughters are having polycystic ovaries because what does the pill do? The pill prevents you from ovulating, which means your androgens have to be high and and so on. So because of ancestry, there are some weaknesses that a person may be predisposed to. And what you have to do now is to change that situation. If you go on natural foods I'm talking about, you do that for 21 days, then you'll be amazed at what can happen with your Lyme disease. Because sometimes a lot of people eat healthy foods, but not for them. Let me give an example. There was a guy that I had to work with. He was plant-based, totally
He's
plant-based.
totally bad.
Yeah, he was totally plant-based, and yet he had fungus. Fungus growing, they would not go away. Didn't matter what he did, he went to many doctors. But when I did the assessment with him, I asked him, I said, "Do you eat a lot of fruit?" He said, "Yes." I said, "Okay. Fungus love sugar. So he's eating healthy food, you know." I said, "Take out the fruit." He said, "What?" I said, "Yeah, take the fruit out." He said, "No." I said, "Yes, take out the fruit. Stop eating fruit, especially sweet fruit." Now he could eat other fruits. He could eat tart fruits like okras and chocho and pumpkin and eggplant. He could eat those, but not mangoes and so on. So he decided, okay, I'm going to try it. He took the fruit out, and within 1 week, 75% reduction in symptoms. He put the fruit back in the following week, symptoms came back. So then he knows, wow, this may be a point. And then he took the food out again, and the symptoms started decreasing gradually. Then we added minerals. We added a powerful, what we call antibiotic essential oil, Ravensara aromatica. And now he's free of the fungal infection. So there are things that are good, but not good for certain people. When you have certain races and when you have certain conditions. So when I did his assessment also, I recognized that he had a bad relationship with his father. His relationship with his father, so he had no grounding. There was no sugar in his life. So he ate a lot of sugar. He ate a lot of fruit as what we call, he was self-medicating, but not knowing he's damaging himself by having so much fruit in his life. So it's that's why now it's not always easy to say do this and do that without an assessment, because most situations are complex. Yeah, but like those little tips, go natural, go back to God, eat food in as natural a state as possible, and try that for a time. Do what we call an elimination diet, a mild food diet, and you will see the body has the beautiful capacity to restore itself as we go back to God's ideal.
I am vegan. I've been vegetarian for
That's fine.
decades and vegan, but I hear what you're saying about the sugar. Quick question is, what is Lyme disease considered? Is it under the category of candida or fungus, or like what is it?
Well, there are many things that are happening in Lyme disease. What I would suggest you do is, you can, Doc, you can put my contact in the chat, or Sister Rhonda, and we can do a one-on-one where I could give some more information, because I'm seeing a lot of questions that are coming up in the chat that we want to probably just get some of them. All right?
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
I'm
You're
sorry, Brother
welcome.
Bob. What did you just say? I missed
You
that.
can
You said
put my
Sarah.
contact.